The day I learned to keep silent wasn't a dramatic moment. It was a warm afternoon in 1992, and I was sitting in a small cafe in Detroit, doing what I thought I did best, talking about all my accomplishments, my upcoming books, my speaking engagements. I was sharing everything with a stranger sitting next to me at the counter, feeling quite proud of myself. That's when an elderly gentleman, who had been quietly sipping his coffee two seats away, turned to me and said something that would change my life forever. "Son," he said, "the mighty river runs silent, while it's a small creek that makes all the noise." Those words stopped me mid-sentence. For the first time in my life, I truly understood what my father had tried to teach me years ago. You see, I had spent years building what I thought was a reputation, but what I was really doing was diminishing my own power, one conversation at a time. I remember driving home that day, replaying every conversation I'd had over the past month. How many times had I volunteered information nobody asked for? How often had I felt the need to prove myself through words rather than actions? The realization was both humbling and liberating. Let me ask you something. When was the last time you felt compelled to tell someone about your achievements, about your plans, about your dreams? We all do it. We live in a world that encourages us to share, share, and then share some more. But today I want to talk about something different. I want to talk about the power of keeping silent. I spent decades counseling people, writing books, giving speeches. But this message, this truth about the power of selective sharing might be the most important thing I've ever shared. Because what I learned that day in Detroit wasn't just about being. It was about understanding the profound difference between proving your worth and actually living it. This isn't going to be a comfortable conversation. Some of what I share might make you squirm in your seat. You might recognize yourself in my stories, and that's okay. Because today, we're going to explore why the most powerful people in your life are often the ones who share the least about themselves, and how you can harness that same quiet power. That elderly gentleman in the cafe never told me his name. He never shared his achievements or his credentials, but his impact on my life was more profound than that of many scholars I'd studied under. And that, my friends, is exactly what we're going to talk about today. You know what fascinates me? How we become a society of town criers, each of us standing on our digital soapboxes, announcing every detail of our lives, back in 1995, just before this technological revolution really took hold, I witnessed something remarkable at one of my seminars. A successful businessman, let's call him Robert, approached me during a break. He had built a thriving manufacturing company from nothing, but something was troubling him deeply. He said, "I've spent 20 years building this business, but lately I feel like I'm losing grip on everything I've created." As we talked, he revealed how he had started sharing every aspect of his business journey, his strategies, his contracts, his future plans, all in the name of being transparent and inspiring others. Within 18 months, three of his competitors had replicated his unique manufacturing process. A key employee had left, taking client relationships with them. His competitive advantage, built over two decades, had evaporated like morning dew in the summer. Here's what I told Robert that day. "And what I want to share with you, your life is not a reality show. Your success is not a documentary that needs to be broadcast live. Think about the most successful people you know personally. Not celebrities, not social media stars, but real people who have achieved genuine success. Notice something about them. They rarely talk about what they're going to do. They just do it. They don't broadcast their strategies, they execute them. In my years of studying human behavior, I've noticed a fascinating pattern. The more people talk about their future plans, the less likely those plans are to materialize. It's as if each time we share our dreams, we release a little bit of the energy needed to achieve them. Let me share something personal. In the early days of my career, I made this mistake countless times. I would tell everyone about the book I was writing, the program I was developing, the changes I was making in my life. You know what happened? That instant gratification of sharing. That momentary eye of people saying, "Wow, that's amazing," and actually decreased my motivation to complete these projects. Why? Because our brains are fascinating organs. When we share our goals and receive praise for them, our brain actually registers a sense of achievement before we've done anything. It's like eating the dessert before you've cooked the meal. We've been conditioned to believe that sharing is always positive. Share your journey, they say. Be transparent, they insist. But nature's most powerful forces work in silence. A seed doesn't announce it's growing. It just grows. Every time you share your unfinished work, your half-baked plans, your future goals, you're not just sharing information. Diluting your power, inviting unnecessary competition, opening yourself to energy vampires, reducing your motivation, creating premature expectations. I remember a conversation I had with a wise teacher in India back in 1987. He told me, in silence, power grows. In sharing, power flows. I didn't fully understand it then, but now its meaning is crystal clear. Look at the device in your pocket, your phone. Look at how it's trained us to share every moment, every thought, every plan. But ask yourself, has all this sharing made us more successful, more fulfilled? Or has it just made us more anxious, more desperate for validation, more scattered in our energy? Robert, the businessman I mentioned earlier, he made a dramatic change after our conversation. He stopped sharing his business strategies online. He quit giving detailed interviews about his processes. He focused on doing rather than talking about doing. Within 2 years, he had rebuilt his competitive advantage and expanded into 3 new markets. The real power, my friends, lies not in what you share, but in what you keep sacred, in what you nurture in silence until it's ready to be revealed through results, not words. What would happen if, for just 1 month, you kept your plans to yourself? If you channeled all that energy you spend sharing into actual doing, the answer might surprise you. But before we explore that further, let's understand the mysterious power that comes with being selective about what we share. Have you ever noticed how a magician never reveals their secrets? There's profound wisdom in that practice beyond just protecting trade secrets. Let me share something with you that changed my perspective forever. In the early 1980s, I had the privilege of knowing a man named Thomas. He lived in a modest home in Philadelphia, drove an ordinary car, and wore simple clothes. Nothing about his external appearance suggested anything remarkable. But there was something about him that drew people in like a magnetic force. It wasn't until years after knowing him that I discovered he had quietly built one of the largest private foundations supporting education in the state. He had helped hundreds of students attend college, funded numerous research projects, and transformed entire communities. Not once had he ever mentioned these achievements in our many conversations. When I asked him why he kept these remarkable accomplishments to himself, he said something I'll never forget. "Wayne, a lighthouse doesn't make noise to attract ships. It simply shines." Think about the people who have truly influenced your life. Not the ones who told you how influential they were, but the ones who actually changed something in you. Chances are, you had to discover their greatness gradually, like uncovering a treasure. I've counseled thousands of people over the years, and I've noticed a consistent pattern. Those who constantly talk about their achievements often feel the least satisfied with them. It's as if they're trying to convince themselves as much as others. Here's what happens when you maintain a sense of mystery. First, you become more intriguing. People become curious about you naturally, without you having to draw attention to yourself. They lean in when you speak because they know you only speak when you have something valuable to say. Second, you maintain your power. Every time you resist the urge to share unnecessarily, you're banking that energy. It's like compound interest for your personal power. Third, you gain a remarkable advantage in both personal and professional relationships. When others don't know your next move, they can't interfere with it, intentionally or unintentionally. Let me tell you about a practice. I began in 1983. I started keeping a private achievement journal. Instead of sharing my accomplishments with the world, I would write them down. When I felt the urge to tell someone about a success, I would add it to my journal instead. The results were astonishing. Not only did my achievements feel more meaningful, but I noticed people became more interested in my work, not less. They started asking questions instead of waiting for me to tell them. The dynamic had completely shifted. Consider the oak tree in your backyard. It doesn't announce its growth each season. It doesn't call a press conference when it grows another inch. It simply grows silently, consistently, powerfully, And one day, people look up and notice its majesty. This is the power of mystery. It's not about being secretive or deceptive. It's about understanding that your energy is sacred and not everything needs to be shared. I once met a martial arts master who told me the highest form of power is the power that's never displayed. Think about that for a moment. The mere possibility of what you might be capable of can be more powerful than any demonstration. You see, when you stop telling people about everything you're doing, something magical happens. You create space for them to discover you. And what people discover for themselves is infinitely more impactful than what you tell them. Now, you might be thinking, but Wayne, doesn't this go against everything we're taught about networking and personal branding? And that's exactly why we need to talk about the five silent strengths that every truly successful person embodies. Let me share with you the five strengths I've observed in people who command genuine respect and achieve lasting success. These aren't techniques or strategies. They're ways of being that transform how the world responds to you. Strength one, actions speak louder than words. In 1978, I met a woman who ran a small publishing house. She never talked about her vision for the company or announced her plans. She simply executed. While her competitors held press conferences about their upcoming projects, she quietly acquired promising authors and built solid relationships. Within 5 years, her company became one of the most respected in the industry. Every time you feel the urge to tell someone about what you're going to do, channel that energy into actually doing it. Let your results make the noise. Strength two, the art of listening. Have you noticed how the most magnetic people in any room are often the ones who listen the most? They create a space for others to share while maintaining their own mystery. This isn't just about being quiet. It's about developing true curiosity about others while protecting your own energy. I remember a CEO I worked with in 1990. During meetings, he would speak last, if at all. Everyone else would share their thoughts, plans, and ideas. He would absorb, observe, and then make decisions that seemed almost prophetic. His power came not from what he said, but from what he heard. Strength three, the power of observation. Those who share less see more. When you're not busy talking about yourself, you start noticing things others miss. You see patterns in behavior, opportunities in the market, and truths beneath the surface. In 1985, I watched two entrepreneurs pitch their businesses at the same conference. One spent an hour detailing every aspect of his business plan. The other simply demonstrated his product and watched the audience's reaction. Guess which one succeeded? The observer understood his market better because he spent more time watching and less time talking. Strength four. Building true self-worth. The less you need to prove your worth to others, the more worthy you become in their eyes. Your self-worth must be like an artesian well, flowing from within, not dependent on external validation. Picture a tree growing in your backyard. It doesn't need to announce its growth or justify its existence. It simply grows, draws nourishment from its roots, and offers its gifts naturally. This is true self-worth. Strength, creating genuine curiosity. When you keep aspects of your life private, you create natural intrigue. People become genuinely interested in what you do, rather than being told what you do. This isn't about playing games. It's about understanding the human psyche. In 1992, I observed two professors at a prestigious university. One constantly shared his research and achievements. The other simply focused on his work. Over time, students and colleagues were far more intrigued by the quiet professor, often seeking his mentorship and insights. These five strengths work together to create something remarkable, authentic power. Not the kind that needs to be announced, but the kind that's felt the moment you walk into a room. Think about someone who has influenced your life deeply. Chances are they possess these five strengths. They didn't need to tell you how important they were. They showed you through their actions, their presence, and their impact. But here's the crucial part. Developing these strengths requires understanding what we lose when we overshare. Let's explore the hidden cost of constantly broadcasting our lives. I've seen it happen countless times in professional settings, careers quietly unraveling, not through major mistakes, but through the subtle erosion of power that comes from oversharing. There was a brilliant surgeon in 1989 who had developed a groundbreaking surgical technique. In his excitement, he began sharing the development process on medical forums before it was fully refined. Within months, others had modified his approach and claimed innovations of their own. His competitive advantage disappeared before it had truly materialized. But the cost runs deeper than just lost opportunities. Every time you share prematurely, you're spending emotional and spiritual currency that you can't get back. Think of your personal power like a bank account. Every unnecessary share is a withdrawal. Every moment of maintained privacy is a deposit. Let me share something that happened in 1994. A young executive came to me for guidance, confused about why she wasn't advancing in her career despite her obvious talent. As we talked, a pattern emerged. She would share her strategic ideas in every meeting, eager to prove her worth. She would tell colleagues about her career plans, seeking validation. She would discuss her challenges openly, thinking it showed authenticity. What she didn't realize was that each share was diminishing her impact. Her colleagues no longer needed to seek her out. They already knew everything she thought, planned, or dreamed. She had become predictable. And in the corporate world, predictability rarely leads to advancement. The energy depletion is real. Have you noticed how exhausted you feel after sharing something personal with a large group? That's not just social fatigue. You're experiencing the energetic cost of dispersing your power. Everything nature protects its most precious resources. A pearl forms in the silence of an oyster shell. Diamonds are created under layers of earth. Your dreams, your plans, your aspirations, these are your precious resources. They deserve the same protection. I witnessed a fascinating transformation in 1991. A small business owner made a conscious decision to stop sharing his company's internal processes and future plans. No more detailed updates on social media. No more revealing business strategies at networking events. Just quiet. Within 6 months, something remarkable happened. His competitors, who had always seemed one step ahead, suddenly couldn't anticipate his moves. Potential clients became more curious about his services. His team became more engaged, feeling they were part of something exclusive rather than just another. The cost of oversharing extends to personal relationships too. When you tell everyone everything, you devalue the intimacy of your closest relationships. Those who should be closest to you no longer feel special in their access to your inner world because everyone has the same access. Think about the most respected person in your field. How much do they share about their personal life, their future plans, their daily challenges? Chances are they understand the power of selective sharing. But there's an even deeper cost, one that affects your very ability to achieve your dreams. When you constantly share your plans, you release the tension necessary for achievement. It's like letting the air out of a balloon before it has the chance to. The solution isn't complete silence. It's understanding the sacred space of privacy. Let's explore how to create that space in your own life. Imagine your life as a sacred temple. Not every visitor deserves access to every room. Yet so many of us have removed all the doors, torn down all the walls, inviting every passerby to wander through our most precious spaces. It's time to rebuild those walls, to understand what truly deserves to be shared and what should be protected. In 1984, I met a man who had built several successful businesses. When asked about his approach to privacy, he shared a simple yet profound practice. He divided his life into three circles. The outer circle was public information. The middle circle was for trusted associates, and the inner circle was just for himself and his closest confidants. Before sharing anything, he would consciously decide which circle it belonged. Think about your own life for a moment. How many times have you shared something and later wished you hadn't? That moment of regret isn't just about embarrassment. It's your inner wisdom telling you that you violated your own sacred space. There's a beautiful paradox in privacy. The more you protect your inner world, the more powerful your external impact becomes. It's like a well deep underground. The more contained it is, the greater the pressure, the stronger its output. When it finally, every major spiritual tradition teaches the importance of silence and privacy. The ancient mystics didn't post their daily meditations on social media. They understood that some experiences are too profound to be shared casually. Let me tell you about Sarah, a writer I worked with in 1993. She had always shared her works in progress, seeking feedback and validation. One day, she decided to keep her latest project completely private until it was finished. The difference was remarkable. The story came through clearer, stronger, uninhibited by others' opinions and expectations. It became her most successful work. Creating healthy boundaries isn't about building walls. It's about installing doors that you control. You decide what to share, when to share it, and with whom. This selective sharing creates a depth to your relationships that constant disclosure never can. The spirituality of silence is profound. In those quiet spaces where you keep your dreams and plans sacred, they gather power. They develop roots before facing the winds of public opinion. They become unshakable. I remember watching a master potter at work in 1988. He wouldn't let anyone see his pieces until they were completely finished. The clay is vulnerable while it's being shaped, he said. It needs protection until it's been strengthened by fire. Your dreams and plans are like that clay. They need protection while they take shape. But how do we practically implement this in a world that demands constant sharing? How do we maintain our privacy without seeming aloof or disconnected? This brings us to the practical steps you can start taking today. Throughout this journey of understanding privacy, remember this. Your power lies not in what you share, but in what you choose to keep sacred. Your dreams, your plans, your deepest aspirations, they deserve to be protected until they're ready to emerge in their full strength. The transformation begins the moment you decide to reclaim your sacred space. The question isn't what you'll share, it's what you'll protect, because in that protection lies the seed of your greatest achievements. Imagine having a powerful personal practice that protects your dreams while still allowing you to move through the world effectively. Over decades of observation and experience, I've discovered a set of practical tools that can transform how you navigate sharing and privacy. The first is what I call the 24-hour pause. When you feel that urge to share something, an achievement, a plan, a goal, wait 24 hours. It's remarkable how many things we think we need to share lose their urgency after it. In 1987, I watched a business leader implement this practice. Everything that still felt important after 24 hours went into one of three categories: must share, could share, or best kept private. Next, develop your inner circle concept. Think of your life as a series of concentric circles. The outer circle is what anyone can know, basic professional information, general life details. The middle circle is for trusted colleagues and friends. The innermost circle, that's your sacred space. Only your closest confidants, if anyone, have access here. Take out a piece of paper. Draw three circles, one inside the other. Now think about everything you've shared in the past week. Where did each piece of information belong? Were you sharing inner circle information in the outer circle? This awareness alone can transform your sharing habits. The achievement journal method is particularly powerful. Instead of sharing your accomplishments, write them down. Document your journey privately. When you feel that urge to tell someone about your success, write it in your journal instead. The power this practice holds is remarkable. A CEO I worked with in 1992 credited this single practice with dramatically increasing his strategic advantage. Let's try something right now. Think of one goal you've been talking about recently. Now imagine sealing it in an envelope for the next month. Don't share it with anyone. Instead, channel all that energy into action. Write about your progress in your private journal. Watch what happens to your focus and momentum. The relevance test. Before sharing anything, ask yourself three questions. Does this person need to know this? What is my true motivation for sharing? Will sharing this enhance or diminish its power? I witnessed the power of this practice through an artist in 1990. She stopped sharing her works in progress and only revealed completed pieces. The mystery around her process actually increased interest in her work and, more importantly, protected her creative energy. Create a power hour each day. 60 minutes where you focus solely on your most important work, with no sharing, no social media, no external input. This is your time to build your dreams in sacred silence. Remember the bank account metaphor? Every time you choose not to share unnecessarily, you're making a deposit in your power account. Every time you practice selective sharing, you're investing in your future impact. Start small. Choose one area of your life to practice privacy this week. Maybe it's a project you're working on or a goal you're pursuing. Keep it completely to yourself. Notice how this feels. Notice the energy you preserve. Notice how your relationship with your own dreams deepens. The transformation won't happen overnight, but with each conscious choice to protect your sacred space, you build momentum. Your power grows in silence, like a seed taking root beneath the soil. These aren't just techniques. They're gates to a new way of being, a way that honors your dreams enough to protect them until they're ready to emerge in their full strength. As we draw this journey to a close, let me share one final story that brings everything we've discussed into sharp focus. In 1982, I encountered two entrepreneurs starting similar businesses. One spoke constantly about his plans, sharing every detail with anyone who would listen. The other worked quietly, revealing nothing until her business was established. 5 years later, one had built an empire while the other was still talking about what he planned to do. The difference wasn't in their capabilities. It was in their understanding of this fundamental truth. Power grows in silence. Your dreams are like rare gems. Their value isn't diminished by keeping them protected. In fact, their worth often multiplies in the sacred space of privacy. Think about where you are right now. Think about all of the times you felt compelled to share your plans, your achievements, your dreams. Now imagine redirecting all that energy into actual creation. Imagine the power you'll accumulate by keeping your sacred spaces truly sacred. This isn't about becoming secretive or disconnected. It's about understanding that not everything needs to be shared. It's about recognizing that your most precious goals deserve protection while they take root and grow strong. Starting tomorrow, make a commitment to yourself. Choose one important goal or project and keep it completely private. Don't share it on social media. Don't announce it to your colleagues. Simply work on it in silence, letting your results speak for themselves. Remember that ancient wisdom. The mighty river runs silent, while it's the small creek that makes all the noise. Which would you rather be? The one who talks about achievement, or the one who achieves? The one who announces their power, or the one who embodies it? The choice is yours. And it begins with the very next thing you choose not to share. It begins with understanding that your power grows every time you resist the urge to prove yourself through words. It multiplies every time you let your actions speak instead of your voice. In this noisy world, be the quiet force that moves mountains. Be the one whose achievements others talk about because you're too busy creating them to talk about them yourself. Your silence will become your strength, your privacy, your power. The transformation begins now, in this moment, with your next decision about what to share and what to protect. Your future achievements are waiting in the sacred space of silence. Protect them, nurture them, let them grow strong before you reveal them to the world. The people who change the world rarely talk about how they're going to do it. They simply do it. And that's what I invite you to do starting today. Let your silence be your strength, and let your achievements be your voice. Go forth now, not to tell the world what you'll become, but to become it. Your greatness awaits in the sacred space of silence. And that, my friends, is the most powerful truth I can share with you today. Stand up, walk out of here different than when you walked in. Not because of what I've said, but because of what you've decided to keep sacred from this moment forward. Your journey to true power begins with what you choose not to share. The most powerful moves in life are the ones nobody sees coming. Be that force. Be that power. Be that silence that changes everything.